Good evening, everyone, and Merry Christmas. Wow. My name is Rick Mullen. I'm one of the associate pastors here at Morningstar, and we have a really, really special evening in store for you, and we're so glad that you've joined us this year for our Christmas Eve service. What you're going to see tonight is not only the story of Jesus' birth, but the why behind his coming, and it's going to be really special. And we hope that you get a glimpse of God's grand plan and how Christ's birth is central to his plan of bringing his kingdom here on earth. And while there's going to be some performance elements like acting and narration and storytelling, we're going to sing songs as well. So we encourage you to join in with us throughout the evening. Let us make it an opportunity for us to join together and worship King Jesus and really allow God to reveal himself in a new, fresh way to us this evening. And I am so excited that we're all here to celebrate together, and little ones, grandparents, friends, and family. It's really awesome, and we're really excited to be here with you this evening. So without further ado, I give you Christmas Eve 2021.
First, this. God created the heavens and earth. All you see, all you don't see. Earth was a soup of nothingness, a bottomless emptiness, an inky blackness. God's spirit brooded like a bird above the watery abyss. God spoke.
Light.
And light appeared. God saw that light was good and separated light from dark. God named the light day. He named the dark night. It was evening. It was morning. Day one. God spoke. Let us make human beings in our image. Make them reflecting our nature so they can be responsible for fish in the sea and birds in the air, the cattle, and yes, earth itself, and every animal that moves on the face of earth. God created human beings. He created them godlike, reflecting God's nature. He created them male and female. God blessed them. Prosper, reproduce, fill earth, take charge. Be responsible for fish in the sea and birds in the air, and for every living thing that moves on the face of earth. You know the story of how Adam landed us in the dilemma we're in. First, sin, then death. And no one exempt from either sin or death. That sin destroyed relationship with God in everything and everyone. So death, this huge abyss separating us from God, dominated the landscape from Adam to Moses. Even those who didn't sin precisely as Adam did by disobeying a specific command of God still had to experience this termination of life, this separation from God. But Adam, who got us into this, also points ahead to the one who will get us out of it.
Thou long expected Jesus.
Jesus, born to set thy people free from our fears and sins. Release us, let us find.
Dark land, a light will shine upon them.
For a child will be born to us, a son will be given to us, and the government will rest on his shoulders, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace.
There will be no end to the increase of his government, or of peace on the throne of David and over his kingdom.
To establish it and to uphold it with justice and righteousness from then on and forevermore, the zeal of the Lord of armies will accomplish this.
Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and she will name him Emmanuel.
You draw the hearts of shepherds, you draw the hearts of kings, and even as a baby you were changing everything. You called me to your kingdom before your lips could speak, and even as a baby you were reaching out for me.
And now we are
Please be seated.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God's presence to an unmarried girl named Mary, living in Nazareth, a village in Galilee. She was engaged to a man named Joseph, a true descendant of King David. Gabriel appeared to her and said, "Rejoice, beloved young woman, for the Lord is with you, and you are anointed with great favor." Mary was deeply troubled over the words of the angel and bewildered over what this may mean for her. But the angel reassured her, saying, "Do not yield to your fear, Mary, for the Lord has found delight in you and has chosen to surprise you with a wonderful gift. You will become pregnant with a baby boy, and you are to name him Jesus. He will be supreme and will be known as the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God will enthrone him as king on the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign as king of Israel forever, and his reign will have no limit." Mary said, but how could this happen? I'm still a virgin." Gabriel answered, "The Spirit of holiness will fall upon you, and Almighty God will spread his shadow of power over you in a cloud of glory. This is why the child born to you will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God. Not one promise from God is empty of power. Nothing is impossible with God." Then Mary responded, saying, "Yes, I will be a mother for the Lord. As his servant, I accept whatever he has for me. May everything you have told me come to pass." And the angel left her. Now Joseph went from the Galilean town of Nazareth up to Bethlehem in Judah, David's town, for the census. As a descendant of David, he had to go there. He went with Mary, his fiancée, who was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for her to give birth, and she gave birth to a son, her firstborn. And she wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the hostel.
Please stand with us.
All he brings, risen with healing in
back on that verse again. Sing Hail.
Hail the heaven-born Prince of Peace. Hail the Son of Righteousness. Light and life to all he brings. Risen with healing in his wings. Vilely laid his glory by. Born that man no more may die. Born to raise the sons of earth. Born to give him second birth. Hark the herald angels sing. Glory to the newborn King.
Awesome. You may be seated.
There were shepherds camping in the neighborhood. They had set night watches over their sheep, and suddenly God's angel stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. They were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I'm here to announce a great and joyful event that is meant for everybody worldwide. A Savior has just been born in David's town, a Savior who is Messiah and Master. This is what you're to look for, a baby wrapped in a blanket and lying in a manger." At once, the angel was joined by a huge angelic choir singing God's praises.
One, two, three, four.
Glory to God, glory to God in the highest. Peace to all people on earth.
Everybody clap those hands, come on.
Glory to God. Glory to God in the highest. Peace to all people on earth.
One more time. Glory, glory, glory.
Glory to God. Glory to God in the highest. Peace to all people on earth.
As the angel choir withdrew into heaven, the shepherds talked it over. Let's get over to Bethlehem as fast as we can and see for ourselves what God has revealed to us. They left running and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. Seeing was believing. They told everyone they met what the angels had said about this child, and all who heard the shepherds were impressed.
Rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born upon this day. To save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. From God our heavenly Father, this blessed angel came, and unto certain shepherds brought tidings of the same, how that in Bethlehem was born the Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Star of night, star with royal blue God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay.
The shepherds returned and let loose, glorifying and praising God for everything they had heard and seen. It turned out exactly the way they had been told. In Jerusalem at the time, there was a man, Simeon, a good man, a man who lived in the prayerful expectancy of help for Israel, and the Holy Spirit was on him. The Holy Spirit had shown him that he would see the Messiah of God before he died. Led by the Spirit, he entered the temple. As the parents of the child Jesus brought him in to carry out the rituals of the law, Simeon took him in his arms and blessed God. Lord and Master, I am your loving servant, and now I can die content, for you have fulfilled your promise to me. With my own eyes, I have seen your word, the Savior you sent into the world. He will be glory for your people Israel, and the revelation light for all people everywhere. Mary and Joseph stood there, awestruck over what was being said about their baby. Simeon then blessed them and prophesied over Mary, saying, "A painful sword will one day pierce your inner being, for your child will be rejected by many in Israel, and the destiny for your child is this. He will be laid down as a miracle sign for the downfall and resurrection of many in Israel. Many will oppose this sign, but it will expose to all the innermost thoughts of their hearts before God." Anna, the prophetess, was also there. She was by now a very old woman. She never left the temple area, worshiping night and day with her fastings and prayers. At the very time Simeon was praying, she showed up, broke into anthem of praise to God, and talked about the child to all who were waiting expectantly for the freeing of Jerusalem. When they finished everything required by God and the law, they returned to Galilee and their own town, Nazareth. There, the child grew strong in body and wise in spirit, and the grace of God was on him.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim the release to captives and the restoration of sight to the blind, to bring peace to those who may be oppressed, to proclaim the favorable year of the Lord.
Shout and cheer, daughter Zion. Raise your voice, daughter Jerusalem. Your king is coming, a good king who makes all things right.
There we go, let's celebrate.